That was the scene last night here at Perry Field as the Florida Gators took a doubleheader from the Mississippi State Bulldogs, and game three of the series coming up in just a few moments. I'm David Steele along with Nick Belmonte. We welcome you to Sports Channel Florida for this afternoon's game. The Gators played very well in yesterday's doubleheader. For Mississippi State, Nick, a little bit of bad luck.
A little bit of bad luck. Pete Young, the third baseman, got some food poisoning. You might want to say he was eating some shrimp. You might want to say the bad batter got the Mississippi State batter out of the lineup, but he's back in there today. Bobby Reed, a pitcher that's ranked number one in the SEC, 8-0, 1.09 ERA, has a sore elbow. He won't be here. He didn't even make the trip. He's scheduled to start today. He usually starts the Sunday game. He won't be on the mound. They're going to go with Chuck Holly, a freshman. So it's going to be interesting to see how they come back with this freshman as opposed to the number one pitcher in the SEC. So that has been bad luck for Mississippi State this weekend.
Florida with the doubleheader has moved into first place in the conference coming into this afternoon's game. Now let's take a look at this afternoon's starting lineups. Leading it off for the Mississippi State Bulldogs is the catcher, Barry Winter. Second, playing right field, John Cohen. Jody Hurst, the designated hitter for this afternoon's game. Hurst had four base hits in yesterday's doubleheader. Richie Graham, who had a three-run home run in game number one of the doubleheader, plays left field, bats fourth. Pete Young will play third base and bat fifth. Tommy Raffo, a two-run blast in game one of yesterday's doubleheader, will bat sixth and play first base. Brad Hildreth, the shortstop, bats seventh. Todd Nace, the center fielder, will bat eighth. And the second baseman will be Burke Masters, hitting in the number nine spot. Starting pitcher for Mississippi State here in this third game of the weekend series is right-hander Chuck Holly. Holly, with a record of two wins and two losses, a 2.48 earned run average, has worked in 11 games and has thrown 36 and a third innings. So it'll be Holly on the mound, and here's the lineup he'll face this afternoon. The leadoff man for the Florida Gators, left fielder Brian Remsnyder. Tommy Edwards, the hero of game two last night in the doubleheader, or game one rather, with the run-scoring triple in the sixth inning, will bat second, play second base. Shortstop Julio Mendez bats third. Designated hitter, the cleanup man Mario Linares. The right fielder Ned Brigham bats fifth. First baseman Tim Oxley bats sixth. Jose Fernandez will catch and bat seventh. Third baseman Alan Rutledge will bat in the eighth position. And Mike Moberg, the center fielder, bats ninth. Starting pitcher for the Gators, big right-hander Joe Klansnick. Klansnick with a record of 2-0, a 5.31 earned run average. So it'll be the right-hander Klansnick against the right-hander Holly, and we'll be underway in just a moment on Sports Channel Florida.
Fans, your old buddy Albert the Alligator here to remind you that now is the best time to buy your official University of Florida license tag. They're available now at your local tag office, and you don't have to wait till your old tag expires to get one. There's one for each state university, and the extra money you pay goes to improve academic programs at your school. So it's a smart investment.
That's right, Albert. It's a smart investment, and it shows you care about the University of Florida. So Gator fans, show your colors.
Here are the Florida Gators defensively as the homestanding ball club on the field and set to start this afternoon's game. Jose Fernandez behind the plate, Tim Oxley at first, Tommy Edwards at second, Julio Mendez at short, Alan Rutledge at third. The outfield of Brian Remsnyder in left, Mike Moberg in center, and Ned Brigham in right field. And there's the starting pitcher, Joe Klansnick, right-hander, a junior from Niles, Illinois.
See Joe's stats right there, 2-0 on the year. He's a guy that's had a lot of starts, but his record is not reflecting it. 2-0, a lot of no decisions. And Joe Klansnick, as you look right there, 61 innings, 51 strikeouts, 40 walks. And it's the 40 walks that have gotten him in trouble. And he's a guy that they say sometimes concentrates a little bit too much. If he doesn't throw the perfect pitch, it gets to him a little bit. He needs to just relax, and if he doesn't throw a pitch right where he wants, just forget about it and go after the pitcher or the hitter on the next pitch. So that's something we're going to key on today, especially if he starts getting wild.
We had some audio problems early in this afternoon's telecast, and for that we apologize. Things appear to be straightened away now, and we're set to go from Perry Field in Gainesville, Florida. Very warm and humid, overcast afternoon. And we're hoping for nothing like a repeat of the Auburn Sunday afternoon game.
What Auburn Sunday afternoon? I'm not even going to bring it up, because I was the guy that predicted no rain that day.
Chatting with Mike Moberg, Florida center fielder, before this afternoon's game, and I was asking him about the effects of hauling that tarp on and off the field that afternoon. He said it was immeasurable, that he was simply exhausted after the second go-round with that tarp on that wet ball field.
Yeah, because it gathered up so much rain, and it was twice as heavy the second time around. And I know the Gator coaching staff said the players' legs were all like jelly after they took the tarp off for the second time. But the sun is out today, David.
Florida with a 15-5 record in the Southeastern Conference. After the sweep last night of Mississippi State, the Bulldogs fell to 13-7. First pitch is inside to Bulldog catcher Barry Winford. LSU split a doubleheader last night with Georgia, so LSU is a game behind Florida. The Gators currently lead the Southeastern Conference. There you see the standings, as even with the loss here against Mississippi State, Florida can do no worse than come out of this tied for first place in the conference. With six conference games to go, two more weekends of regular season action. The 1-1 pitch from Klansnik. Winford leads it off with a single. Now, Mississippi State struck quickly last night in both games. They jumped all over Florida starting pitchers. Got three runs in the first game of the doubleheader last night. Got a run, their only run, in the second game in the first inning. Right fielder John Cohen faces the right-handed Joe Klansnik. Winford with pretty good speed, leading off at first. Ball is ripped into the gap in left center field, up against the fence. Winford legging it around second. He's going to try to score. Here comes the relay from Mendez, and the throw to the plate will not be in time. It's a double for John Cohen, and Mississippi State strikes quickly in the top of the first inning at Perry Field.
Well, two pretty well-hit balls. Cohen didn't wait a long time for that one. Jumped on the first pitch, rode it right into left center field. It's important that Mississippi State jumps out to an early lead here, because after last night's sweep, the momentum all on the Gators. They need to turn it around early, and with the help of that double, they might do just that.
And that was Cohen's first hit of the series. He jumped all over that fastball from Klansnik. Cohen down at second base. And Joni Hurst steps to the plate. Hurst is the only Bulldog who really consistently hit Florida pitching yesterday. Already some action down in the Gator bullpen. There's a well-hit ball at Julio Mendez at short. He's going to try and get the out at third. Rutledge puts the tag on, and they nail Cohen at third base. Heads-up play by Mendez, and Rutledge put on the tag for the first down in the inning.
Well, base running mistake by Cohen, and you wonder how it's going to affect the rest of the inning. Ball was in front of him. It was a pretty hard hit ball. He needs to make sure that ball goes through. And Mendez, with the heads-up play, as you said, David, had a fairly easy play once he got the ball cleanly.
Richie Graham, but the throw over first got away from Oxley at first base. And Hurst is down to second. He's going to go for three. And is in standing up. So the throwing error by Klansnik has put a Bulldog runner at third anyway with one out in the inning.
Yeah, that base running mistake by Cohen makes no difference now, because there would have been no one on first. Actually, they're doing a little bit better. Now they have a runner on third. Had he not made the base running mistake, he would only have been at second. It's been a strange weekend.
Base running blunder last night by Mississippi State resulted in a double play, and the guy at the plate was a part of that, if I recall correctly. He and Hurst were the players in that double play that were on the base pants. The 0-1 pitch. One ball and one strike to Richie Graham.
The play you're referring to, Graham was the hitter. He singled with Hurst on first base. And he singled actually into a double play, and he was on the tail end of that, and he was the guy that got the base hit.
Hurst got caught between second and third. They tagged him out. And then Graham got thrown out back at first as he overran the base and was caught halfway between first and second. The 1-1 pitch, check swing, foul. One ball and two strikes, one out, top half of the first inning from Perry Field in Gainesville, Florida. Klansnik has only thrown one complete game, and that was a seven-inning conference game against the Alabama Crimson Tide. He shut Alabama out in seven innings, a four-hitter. That has been by far his best outing. He hasn't worked more than four innings in his last four appearances. The 1-2. Squipped to Mendez and took a funny hop and got past him into left field. It's 2-0. Ball had a lot of spin on it, and Julio was just fooled on a ground ball.
Yeah, there's no way they're going to get anybody at the plate as the Gators playing it back early in the ball game. Remember, we have this game is nine innings, not like the seven-inning games last night in the doubleheader. But that ball had a lot of spin on it and took a tricky hop, and they're going to rule it an error, however.
Stepping to the plate is number 31, third baseman Pete Young.
The 14th error committed this year by Mendez at shortstop. Pete Young, the third baseman, at the plate. With the runner on first, the fastball brushed him back. Young did not play last night except for a late pinch hitter's role in the second game of the doubleheader. He struck out. But he's hitting 354. And has nine home runs. Second on the club. Fastball just missed the outside corner. It's 2-0.
And a guy in the lineup today, Pete Young, as you said, David, that can either pitch or play third or do both, as he's done so many times this year. He is a relief pitcher, and you may see him in there today.
Foul back behind home plate. Two balls and a strike.
Ron Polk seems to think that Pete Young could possibly make it in professional baseball as a hitter or a pitcher. He said he's that good of a pitcher.
Fernandez took a belt to the mask, and the count evens at 2-2.
So all you people want to be catchers, huh? Watch this. This is all in a day's work. Uh-huh. Like unmasking Jason.
Right at Rutledge. He's got a shot at two. Double play to win the inning. Graham wandered too far off the bag, and the Gators double him up. But the Bulldogs get two runs on a couple of hits. We move to the bottom of the first with Mississippi State up 2-0.
When I was playing hockey, I wore special equipment for protection against injury. I'm Gordie Howe reminding you that in a car, you also need the protection of a seatbelt to guard against possible injury in an automobile accident. By wearing a seatbelt, you can cut the odds of being fatally injured in an accident by over 50%. Wearing a seatbelt is more than a good idea. It is now the law in the state of Connecticut. Be a winner and buckle up.
This is my niece, Mary Devon. She's 11 years old. I asked her to help me warn people that smoking's bad for them. And she said she hates smoking so much, she didn't even want to talk about it. So I said, fine, she could just sit here and not talk about it if she wanted to. But Mary Devon, honey, now that you're here with a chance to influence millions of people, isn't there anything you want to tell the cigarette smokers of America?
Don't.
That's my niece. She'll talk your ear off if you let her.
Well, the base running adventures of Richie Graham continue. You'll see the one here in the top of the first inning. It's the double play. You're taught to freeze on a liner. He freezes a little bit too late, and by the time he gets back, Rutledge's throw from third is there in plenty of time.
Leading off for the Gators is the left fielder, number 15, Brian Redeknyder.
Chuck Holly on the mound, a freshman from Ioka, Mississippi. Facing the left-handed hitting Brian Redeknyder to lead off the bottom of the first. Redeknyder swung the bat well yesterday. Says he was feeling a lot more comfortable. He's been struggling recent games, but he said he felt good at the plate yesterday. The 2-0. Two balls and a strike. He also said that he realizes that he has a tendency to take more pitches in that leadoff spot than he does in the number three position. That ball's well hit to right. Cohen makes the catch on the warning track for out number one.
That ball actually sounded funny off the bat. It sounded like it got him about where the trademark would be on a wooden bat. Let's see where he hits it. Because the swing is good. It seems like he just got and jammed him. He got it in a little bit on him. Had it been a couple inches down the barrel, it would have been out of here.
Gators popular second baseman Tommy Edwards, a big day yesterday. Fastball is high for ball one. Edwards, four hits in the doubleheader. Grounder, lunging play by Young. Nicely done by third baseman Pete Young. He showed good range moving to his left. And the big guy just made a fine play. Two outs for the Florida shortstop, Julio Mendez. Couple of hits yesterday.
Now batting is the shortstop, number 10, Julio Mendez.
Working on a five-game hitting streak is Mendez. Fastball on the outside corner for strike one.
That last play by Pete Young, talking to Ron Polk yesterday, he said, you know, for a guy his size, he really will surprise you with his range over third base, and he made a great play.
Over third, you need quickness more than anything else, mm-hmm. And it's not so much speed.
Reaction.
It's how well you react.
Yeah.
You don't have much time to do anything but react down at the hot corner. Over the outstretched arms of Burke Masters for a base hit. Mendez is the first base runner for the Gators.
When we watch Chuck Holly today, a measure of his effectiveness is going to be how many ground balls do the Gators hit. So far they've hit one. He's a sinker ball pitcher, and like all sinker ball pitchers, if they're on, the Gators are going to be hitting a lot of ground balls today. And he does not throw hard. He's a low 80s type pitcher on it when it's fastball, but he moves the ball around, has a pretty good change, but his big pitch, as I said, is the sinker.
Mario struggled at the plate yesterday. He struck out three times in the doubleheader. Let's see how they pitch him today. Yesterday, it was breaking stuff away. Winford sets up outside. That was a fastball over the outside corner for strike one. finally in his last at bat last night in the second game, Linares went with the outside breaking ball and lined a single to right. He admitted today that he was trying to pull those breaking balls early.
It was obvious he was pulling off of everything yesterday, and the hips were flying open, the head was going out. He should just hit it where it's pitched, and he has good power to the opposite field. I've seen him take a few out of the yard right center. So it's not like he does not possess power or the ability to hit the opposite field. He just needs to go with the pitch because he can do that well.
Curveball is up and outside, one and one.
Now, on the other hand, if they come in with a breaking ball inside it hangs, that's the pitch you go get and pull. Or a fastball inner half, go ahead and turn on the ball. But it doesn't seem like Mississippi State is going to throw him that way this weekend.
One ball, two strikes. Last weekend against Ole Miss, Linares had a career for some. Seven hits, eight RBIs, and a three-game series at Oxford. But Mississippi State pitchers must have learned something about the way he handles himself at the plate, because they've pitched him very tough.
Well, let's see. Let's figure this out. Starkville is near Oxford. Perhaps scouts, perhaps?
Could be.
Yeah, never know, huh? I tell you, the following at Mississippi State is tremendous. Anytime you get 14,000 people on campus for a ball game, which was an NCAA record, that's telling you, they just love their Bulldogs in Starkville.
The 2-2 pitch. Call strike three. The Gators come up with no runs in the bottom of the first. Got a base hit and left Mendez stranded at first. We've played a one complete. Bulldogs 2, Gators nothing.
That was the best assembly we ever had.
That's great. I meant what I said. Okay, so what do you do if somebody offers you drugs?
Just say no!
That's right. You can all be winners on and off the court. You owe it to yourselves to be your best. Don't let anyone talk you into playing a losing game with drugs. Play it smart. Don't foul out.
Yeah!
That's the way to say it.
You're Alan Hayes.
Oh, I knew that.
The old guard and the new wave.
To tell you about another down-to-earth benefit from space research.
I can't believe these glasses for the deaf.
A tiny microphone on the frame connects to a portable computer which converts spoken words into visual cues that appear right on the lens of the glasses.
Huh. The eyes doing what the ears can't. Incredible.
Space technology.
This is what's in it for you.
You're looking at the call strike on Mario Linares, a fastball on the outside corner of the plate. And Mario thought it might have been a little low. Home plate umpire Tony Thompson, though, called him out.
That was a sinker that you saw right there. Bonham just dropped out of that one. And
the first baseman, number 22, Tommy.
Tony Thompson thought it had crossed the plate. It was high enough when it had crossed the plate. That's something that... if he gets that call all day, he's going to be real tough.
Tommy Raffo takes the first pitch deep to center field. Moberg, though, is there short of the warning track and makes the catch. That'll bring up the shortstop, Brand Hildreth. And one hit and six official trips yesterday.
Stepping at bat is number four, the shortstop, Brad Hildreth.
He goes after the first pitch. Pops it high to shallow right field. Ned Brigham comes on to make the catch for the second out in the inning. That's the way Klancznik likes to do it. Two pitches, two outs, and the center fielder, Todd Nace, will step to the plate against Klancznik.
Well, two pitches, two outs. That happened to the Gators last night, and Tommy Edwards took forever to get in the batter's box. Let's see if Nace takes a pitch here. One would think he would.
Took a good fastball on the outside corner for strike one. One ball, one strike. Two and one. We're in the top of the second. Mississippi State got two runs in the first. Got a little bit of help from the Gators, who committed two errors in the inning. Only one of the runs was earned. Klancznik has gone 3-1 on Todd Nace. Second baseman Burke Masters waits on deck.
Todd Nace came into this weekend series hitting 282, but had a 425 on base average. So he does walk a lot, and he's got a 3-1 count here.
Called strike two. The count's full with two outs. The pitch from Klancznik. Grounded through the right side for a base hit. Third hit of the game off of Klancznik. And with two outs, second baseman Burke Masters will be the batter. Masters was hitless in five official at bats yesterday.
See how the Bulldogs play it here with two down. They're not a running team.
Nace has stolen a couple of bases this year in three attempts. The Gators really took a lot of pressure off themselves by sweeping that doubleheader yesterday. The 1-0. Grounded foul just outside the bag at third base.
It looked like he was leaning towards second base. And Todd Nace trotting back to first. 1-1 count. Let's see how Ron Polk plays it as Masters looks down. That was interesting. Nace with his lead off of first. When Klancznik went into a stretch, he actually took a step back towards first base. There's Ron Polk. The sign for what they're going to do on this pitch has already been flashed.
Driven to left field. Remsnyder and Moberg both converging, and they have a collision, but Remsnyder holds on to the baseball. A little bit of a communication problem there between Florida's left fielder and center fielder, but they hang on for the third out of the inning. We've played an inning and a half, Bulldogs by two.
Coca-Cola's a part of your life. Oh, and Coca-Cola. Reeves bombs one, aimed this time at Andy Chaney. Big effort, Mr. C.
Ever since I was a player, I've worked hard to support the University of Florida. Now at the Barnett Bank, we have a great way that you can show your support, too. With the Barnett Gator Visa card, Barnett will contribute 10 cents per transaction, plus $7 a year to the university, at no additional cost to you. Every real Gator should have a Barnett Gator Visa card. Apply at any Barnett Bank today.
Here's a look at that last fly ball. Brian Remsnyder calling for it. Moberg with good speed. And no one really, to the last second, makes the call. Remsnyder obviously called off Moberg, but Moberg did not take the outside path and almost tripped him, and that could have been dangerous, David. That would have led to a run.
No doubt about it. They lacked the proper communication out there in left center field, but got away with it that time. Ned Brigham leads off the bottom of the second for Florida. Couple of hits yesterday in the doubleheader, couple of RBIs. Stung the ball well yesterday. Fastball is on the outside corner for strike one.
Got a big triple in the first game, knocking a run. That really got the Gators going in the first one.
Hildreth ranging deep into the infield, and he threw him out. Brad Hildreth showing good range.
And here's the end of the play right here.
We've had some close calls at first.
And there's another one right there.
Florida has not been altogether pleased with
number 34, first base
throughout this
Sam
series, and there's another one. And here's Mr. Sports Channel. And there's an extra base hit. Oxley will be standing up at second with a double.
Well, double number seven for Tim Oxley. Five of those have been on Sports Channel. And if you weren't with us last night, that young man has 14 out of his 19 RBIs on Sports Channel, three of his three home runs on televised games here from Gainesville. And now he's hitting at about a 625 clip. And his slugging percentage is around 1,400. And these are just games that are televised on Sports Channel originating here at home.
Prime time, Oxley down at second. Jose Fernandez steps in to face the freshman right-hander. Goes after the first pitch, a breaking ball, and fouls it into the dugout on the first base side.
Oxley, as you see in the bottom left of your picture, really went down and got that pitch and went with it very nicely. Something that a big left-handed hitter is not inclined to do.
Called strike two. Third baseman Alan Rutledge is on deck. The 0-2. Base hit into center field. They're going to hold Oxley at third. And Florida will have runners on the corners with one out in the bottom of the second.
Well, this is definitely a pitching mistake by the freshman, Chuck Holly. Way ahead in the count, and watch the location of this breaking ball. Right up at the letters, and good hitters hit mistakes, and Jose waited on it and drove it right to center field.
Now batting is the third baseman, number 20, Alan Rutledge.
Gators trying to get some fireworks going here in the bottom of the second, trailing 2-0. Rutledge looking for his first hit of the series. The pitch from Holly. Grounded to third. Pete Young going to come home with it. The tag is put on Oxley, and he's safe. He got under the tag. Said the home plate umpire, John Kramer. And Ron Polk jumped up out of that dugout on the first base side very quickly, and he's nose-to-nose with Mr. Kramer. The ball was there before the runner.
Hey, Raffo, what did I tell you before?
But I guess Kramer says he got under the tag.
Well, just when you thought you've seen it all this weekend, you have some more controversy from Gainesville, and Ron Polk is in danger of getting tossed here.
The home plate umpire is Tony Thompson, I've been informed, not Kramer. So Mr. Thompson getting an earful for Mr. Polk. Ron Polk may be very near to getting himself thrown out of this game.
Well, you got to remember, this is a nine-inning ball game. He might be doing this. I'm sure he's not. This is not a ploy to fire up his team. If it comes to that, then you'll see him really put on a show if he gets tossed. But
this umpiring crew has been under fire all weekend. These guys have earned their money, haven't they? Joe Arnold got tossed out of game two last night. He's kind of enjoying all this. All right, now let's look at it again. Here's what the argument's about. Out or safe?
Well, from that angle, it's tough to tell. The key here is, did the foot beat the tag? And that's as simple as that. From that angle, it was really hard to tell. The throw, on the other hand, definitely beat the base runner. However, more times than not, the umpire will call you out just because the throw beat you there. The proper call is, did the foot beat the tag? From that angle, I could not tell. But I'm sure that is what the call was, that the foot snuck in before the tag was made. And that changes things around drastically.
Mike Moberg at the plate. The Gators with runners at first and second. The lead's been cut in half. It's now 2-1. Score and a fielder's choice. And an RBI for Alan Rutledge. Fastball is outside. One ball, no strikes. Fernandez down at second. Rutledge at first.
The Gators, you have to watch them. Sometimes they'll do that delayed first and second steal.
High chopper down to Pete Young, over his head into left field. One run will score. Rutledge will be held at third. Moberg trying to leg it to second is in, sliding with a double. It's a 2-2 game.
Well, the Bulldogs have to feel like they're snake bit. This is good pitch. He hits it into the ground. It hits that hard dirt around home plate. And Pete Young can only watch it. Mississippi State people were telling me after they worked out on Friday night here, they said this is one of the hardest infields in the SEC.
And thanks to that hard ground, Moberg has his seventh double of the year. Leadoff man Rensnyder takes the first pitch outside for ball one. And the inning is a long way from being over, too, with runners at second and third and only one out. Pat McMahon steps out to the mound to speak with his young right-hander.
And Joe Arnold's coming out to talk to Brian Rensnyder, which is allowed when there's a pitching conference going on. I'm sure McMahon is bringing home the point, son, you haven't made bad pitches. There's been some calls that have gone against you and some ground balls that have gotten through, so it's really not his doing.
Gators have struck for two in the bottom of the second to tie this game up. Rensnyder bats with runners at second and third. And the 1-0 pitch from Holly. Fastball is outside. Two balls and no strikes.
Granted, Oxley's double was hard hit and Fernandez's single was sharply hit, but Rutledge's and Moberg's were not.
Good fastball, 2-1.
With one out, Mississippi State playing the infield back.
They'll concede the run on a ground ball early in the game. Three balls and a strike to Brian Remsnyder. The pitch. He loaded him up.
Walk number 40 for Brian Remsnyder.
Tommy Edwards has a chance to do some serious damage right here with the bases loaded and one out in the inning. Rutledge at third. Moberg at second. Remsnyder at first. Bases loaded with Gators. The pitch from Holly. Edwards takes it right through there for strike one.
It's interesting to see how Mississippi State plays their infield now. Their double play depth up the middle. And they're back at first, and Young creeps in on the pitch.
Masters will get the force at second for one. Hildreth throws across, but Edwards beats the wrap at first, and Rutledge scores with the third run of the inning.
Let's see it right here. I think it was a good call. Outside pitch, he goes with it. Hits it into the ground. 4-6, let's see what happens. Now he beat it.
Florida still with runners at first and third. Now two outs in the inning for shortstop Julio Mendez, who singled in the first. Julio with three hits for the weekend. Holly steps away from the mound and now he's set to face the Gator shortstop.
First and third steal situation, a possibility here.
Curveball is away for ball one. Gators have taken a 3-2 lead in the bottom of the second. Line to center, but right at Todd Nace. But a very productive second inning for the Florida Gators, and they take a 3-2 lead over the Bulldogs.
I know some kids say I'm cool. I can handle drugs. I can take them or leave them. I'm telling you, they can't. No one has been able to handle drugs. No one. Drugs ruin people's lives and hurt everyone around them. There's only one answer. Don't even try drugs. No matter how you say it, say no. Don't foul out with drugs.
Look, I stole for cocaine. See, cocaine torments you till you do anything to get it. You become evil, a real conniver. I'm not that bad of a guy. I'm not that low. When you do cocaine, you lie to yourself about being in control. I got to the point where my life was going down the drain, and I didn't even care. Anyone tells you cocaine's okay, don't believe it.
Call 1-800-662-HELP.
Ron Polk can't be a very happy man at the moment. He, I'm sure, has a feeling that he's on the road and not getting many breaks away from home. And a tough call at home plate that the umpire Thompson apparently ruled that the runner got underneath the tag.
You can never count that man out. 13-13 going into the SEC tournament. The last team to qualify for the tournament last year, they just walked away winning that thing and going to the regional. Just when you think you have Ron Polk down, he's not out. He's proven that many, many times again. And as we said, one of the Olympic coaches this year for the United States team when they go to Seoul, Korea.
Barry Winford led off the game with a single off Klancic in the first inning, takes the first pitch high for ball one. Florida, 3 runs, 4 hits. Mississippi State, 2 runs, 3 hits. The 1-0. Right at Mendez for the out. Hit it right on the nose, but right at shortstop Julio Mendez.
Here's the pitch by Klancic, and Winford takes this low pitch and just drives it right at the shortstop. Good piece of hitting right there, but they say it all evens out in the wash and he'll get a dunker later in the ballgame, but somehow I never believed that.
Right fielder number 11, John Cohen.
Always thought I lined out more than I popped up. Popped in a single anyway.
Cohen lined a double his first trip. Breaking ball is high for ball one. Doubled home Winford. And the first with the Bulldogs' first run of the game. Here's a well-hit ball past Edwards into right field. Cohen is 2 for 2.
There's a guy making up for lost time. Came into this ball game 0 for 7 in the doubleheader last night. And quickly in this one, 2 for 2, and hit the ball well twice.
The hits are all even at 4 apiece as Joni Hurst steps to the plate. He grounded to Mendez in the first. And Julio threw out Cohen trying to go from second to third.
Saw his numbers there yesterday, 4 for 6. And the reason I would think he's DHing today is he has that pulled quadricep muscle in his right leg, and he is not 100%. He was really limping around last night. So they pretty much gave him the day off in the outfield, because that's a lot of running that you have to do from center field to the dugout every inning. So he gives him the afternoon off, and he's just going to DH.
Good look at the crowd, a nice Sunday afternoon shirt sleeve crowd today at Perry Field. Curve ball caught the inside corner. Hurst had 4 hits in the doubleheader of the 14 innings of play, which saw Mississippi State collect only 11 base hits. This is a team that batting 340 coming into the series. The testament to the pitching of Jeff Gidcombe and Johnny Wiggs, who both pitched complete games last night.
Now it's up to Klancic to get out the leading hitter in the Southeastern Conference. Jody Hurst came in the game hitting 403.
Not this time. Hurst nails one into left. Cohen will have to stop at second as Remsnyder throws the ball in. And with one out in the inning, the Bulldogs threaten to score again. Klancic has not exactly been a mystery here in the top of the third. The first man, Winford, hit the ball on the nose at shortstop Mendez, and then Cohen and Hurst have both drilled shots into the outfield for base hits.
Here comes Joe, and I believe he's going to yank him here with the lefty up.
Todd Downer is up throwing in the Florida bullpen, the freshman left-hander from Enid, Oklahoma. And they may be buying a little bit of time here, if nothing else.
I used to play for Joe. I know that look in his eye. He was gone before he even walked out.
Todd Dalma jogging in from the outfield bullpen, and Joe Klancic is going to be through for the afternoon. in a Sunday afternoon game like this, both teams feel like they've essentially got the entire pitching staff to use. And you often see four or five pitching changes in a Sunday afternoon SEC game. Well, while Dalma is warming up, let's take a listen to an interview that Nick Belmonte did before this afternoon's game with the winner of Game 2 last night in the doubleheader, left-hander Johnny Wiggs.
In Italy, they have Michelangelo. In France, they had Renoir. In Gainesville, the Gator pitching staff has Johnny Wiggs. An artist on the way you paint the quarters. Johnny, your style of pitching is fun to watch from up in the booth, the way you go in and out, side to side, up and down. You never throw the ball over the plate, it seems.
that's the plan, to do that, especially good hitters like Mississippi State. And, I've been throwing my pitches well these days with the fastball, the curve, and the slider, and, mixing in the sidearm stuff. So things have been going well so far.
Last night, a couple of situations, a couple of points of controversy where you thought you might have had the guy struck out. Actually, it happened to you twice. You had to strike out two hitters, looked like four strikes. But you had to keep your composure. Is it tough to do that?
Oh, yeah. Both situations, I thought I struck out the guy. But, I had to, keep my composure. And it fired me up a little bit. It got the fans into the game a little bit and my teammates. So, overall, I think it helped us a lot.
The doubleheader sweep last night put you in good position to lead the SEC. What are the thoughts of the team right now going into this third game?
Yeah, we couldn't ask for anything more than, to take two out of, we were looking for two out of three, definitely from these guys. And now we got a chance for three out of three, and I think we got to go out and get today. But, it was great to go ahead and get the pressure off, take two of them last night.
Nick Belmonte speaking with Gator left-hander Johnny Wiggs, and that funny look on his face there during one of the questions, Nick. You guys almost got beamed by a baseball, didn't
you? Yeah, Mississippi State was taking infield, and I don't know if they were trying to get back at Johnny Wiggs for last night's performance or what, but one whizzed by both of our heads. It's a dangerous place to do interviews during infield practice.
So now the left-hander Dalma faces the left-handed hitting Richie Graham, and the first pitch is low and outside for ball one. Graham squipped one off the end of his bat in the first, and Julio Mendez was charged with an error. One of two Florida errors this afternoon. Count evens at 1-1. John Cohen at second base. Jody Hurst at first. The 1-1 from Dalma. Curveball is in for strike two. Dalma worked last weekend against Mississippi. The Sunday afternoon game. He struck him out. First strikeout of the game for a Florida pitcher.
Well, the freshman from Enid, Oklahoma comes in and gets the big strikeout on the power hitting Graham, and that ball just dropped right out of the strike zone and he couldn't catch up with it.
And that is the third baseman, number 31, Pete Young.
Now Dalma gets tested by the right-handed hitting third baseman Pete Young, who lined into a double play in his first trip, waved at the offering from Dalma for strike one.
That pitch almost acted like a screwball the way it tailed outside, and Pete Young, a little anxious with men on base, couldn't catch up with that one.
Mississippi State has hit left-handers hard this year, but they had problems with Wiggs last night. 1-1 to count to Young. And last weekend against Mississippi, Dalma worked four innings in relief and struck out six Rebel batters to pick up the victory. Gave up only one hit in those four innings. The youngest fan at Perry Field.
Maybe they should put another blanket on the poor kid. It's only 90 degrees out.
Looping fly ball into right center field, going to fall in for a base hit. One run will score. The ball gets all the way to the fence. Two runs will score. Young is legging it for third. The relay throw, and he's in safe. A two-run triple for Pete Young. And Mississippi State has taken a 4-3 lead.
Well, the Gators traditionally leave a big opening in right center field. Unfortunately, they haven't been burned that much by it. But here's an outside pitch, and Pete Young does a great piece of hitting and going out and getting it. If you're going to pitch the guy away, you might have to shade over there and play him that way. There was a big hole, and that was the second pitch, and you see Hurst limping in, and now you see Young sliding in head first with the triple. And this game is a seesaw affair. It's now 4-3 Mississippi State, David.
Young now with 43 RBIs for the year. Tommy Raffo, who went after the first pitch from Klansnik, his first trip up and fly to center, will face the left-hander, Todd Dalma. He goes after the first pitch here and waves at the curveball for strike one. Ground ball, right side of the infield. He sneaks it through into right field. Young scores from third, and it is a 5-3 ball game.
Well, this is just what Mississippi State wanted, getting into the Gator bullpen early and getting a lefty on the mound. Now, this is that same type of pitch. It's going away from the hitter. He gets the head of the bat, or actually the top part of the bat on the ball, and just squibs it through. C&I base hit. And Brad Hildreth, the hitter. And last night, when Johnny Wiggs, the left-hander from Florida, beat Mississippi State, that broke a string of 10 left-handed pitchers that had gone down in defeat against Mississippi State. So they feast on lefties.
Dalma throws over to first. Brad Hildreth flying to right. In the second, he's 0 for 1. 1 for 7 in the weekend series. Klansnik worked 2 1/3 innings, gave up 5 hits, 4 runs, 3 of them earned. He didn't walk anybody, and he didn't strike out anybody. Dalma delivers to the plate. Outside, ball one.
See, David, if they're going to pitch with that style of pitching away, they may need to move that outfield and pinch it a little bit in right center field. Because the Mississippi State hitters are good enough that they'll adjust to that pitch tailing away, and they'll just go with it all day long.
Center fielder Mike Moberg shaded to the left. A lot of room in right center. Snap throw by Dalma, and a nice play by Oxley to save it.
Now, if you're going to throw breaking balls to Hildreth, then possibly play him the pull, but it seems like Dalma's pitches usually tail away, and that's the way they're going to attack Mississippi State here.
Hit the outside corner. The 2-1. Runner moving. A stolen base for Tommy Raffo. Only the fourth stolen base of the year by Raffo.
Now watch Raffo. He's actually going to run on the grass, and then he's going to have to come back over. Kind of made it a long journey, but he got the job done. Tommy Raffo.
Yeah.
And that did look like a straight hit and run. Just for the fact that Hildreth offered at it. Usually you do not hit and run with two outs. But that looked to be a hit and run.
The 2-2 pitch. Fouled behind home plate. The inning began harmlessly enough with Barry Winford lining out to short, but then Cohen singled and Hurst singled. Klansnik was lifted. Todd Dalmas struck out Richie Graham for the second out in the inning, but then Pete Young triple home two runs, and then Tommy Raffo brought Young in. Three runs in the inning. A 3-2 count now to the batter, Brad Hildreth. Dalma wants a new baseball.
Dalma with a good success rate in SEC competition, 2.61 ERA. That's 10 and one-third innings of SEC competition.
Fly ball to center. Mike Moberg makes the catch for the third out in the inning. But the Bulldogs get three runs, and they take a 5-3 lead as we move to the bottom half of the third.
Here in this land of plenty, about 10 million people are hungry. Many don't know they're eligible for food stamps. They've lost a job, a farm, or a husband. Food stamps can help. Now one call can get you information to tell you if you qualify for food stamps and how to get them. America has made a place at our table of plenty for you. Call 1-800-453-4000. Meal times don't have to be tough times.
I was a vice president of a Fortune 500 company. I had a beautiful family. A big house in the suburbs, everything I wanted. Then I got into cocaine, and I almost lost it all. It's a lie that cocaine's not addictive. I didn't choose to be an addict. Quitting cocaine was the only thing I couldn't do by myself. I'll be a recovering addict day by day for the rest of my life.
Call 1-800-662-HELP.
Tuesday, April 26th on Sports Channel Florida, it'll be Major League Baseball. Join us live at 8 o'clock when the Baltimore Orioles and Minnesota Twins meet in the Metrodome in Minneapolis. The world champion Minnesota Twins and those lovable Baltimore Orioles right here on Sports Channel Florida. They are going to win one before that game takes place. Nick Belmonte has guaranteed that.
Absolutely. They go against Brett Saberhagen today in Kansas City.
Sharply in on the ground to Hildreth. Mario Linares is the first down in the bottom of the third. That'll bring up Florida right fielder Ned Brigham. Ned wanted me to give a special birthday wish to a good buddy up in Norwood, Massachusetts, watching on the Sports Channel, Danny Slow. Gator third base coach Dave Howard wanted a special hello to Bruce and Peg Seville watching in Winchester, Virginia. The 1-0. Brigham fouls it out of play. One ball, one strike. Ned grounded to short his first trip and the second. He's 2-for-5 in the weekend series with a couple of RBIs. The 1-1 pitch. He slapped it up the middle for a base hit.
Well, happy birthday, Johnny Slow, huh?
And here's the man, Tim Oxley. He doubled in the second. And is otherwise known as Mr. Sports Channel. There's Dave Howard down at third base.
Dave Howard had a funny line last night after Joe Arnold got thrown out of the ball game. Dave said, now I know how the guy Shooter felt in the movie Hoosiers. Because when Gene Hackman got thrown out, the Dennis Hopper character, Shooter, had to take over. He said, I was out there drawing the pick and roll, the pick and fence play.
Brigham with good speed leads at first. Fastball is outside for ball one. Nobody warming up in the Bulldog bullpen. And a 5-3 Bulldog lead in the bottom of the third. And one thing that might happen is your third baseman, Pete Young, could come in to pitch. 2-0.
Pete Young has been the setup man for Mike Martin. I'm sure we're going to see Mike Martin before this day is over, and I'm sure we're going to see Jamie McAndrew before this day is over. But he is the setup man, and since he didn't throw yesterday, his arm is rested.
Holly chases Brigham back to the bag. Ned has been successful on 14 stolen base attempts out of 18 tries. Not going this time. And Oxley's worked Chuck Holly to a 3-0 count. He walked him on four pitches.
Wouldn't be surprised if you don't see activity in the Mississippi State bullpen pretty soon, even though we're in the third. Mississippi State really cannot afford to lose this ball game. They need it worse than the Gators do. And right on cue, Tracy Job heads down to the bullpen.
Stepping up as the catcher, number 24, Jose Fernandez.
And there they are.
Getting Jimmy Gamble up down there. The first pitch is driven to left field, and Graham misplayed that ball and then made the catch. Adventure in outfielding by Richie Graham.
Well, the ball takes a tricky path, and so does Graham going after it. The wind picks it up at the last second, and Graham has to leave his feet and make the catch. And Ned Brigham making the correct play by going halfway only because the ball was hit in front of him in the left field, and at the last second, he noticed that he may be in trouble and he would have scored. Good recovery though by Graham. Wasn't pretty, but it worked.
Fernandez the second out in the inning. Alan Rutledge, who grounded to third and brought a runner in on the very controversial play at the plate. Curveball is on the outside corner, and Holly's out in front of Rutledge 0-2.
Looks like they're pitching Allen away this weekend as well. The book on Rutledge obviously is throw him away. Most of his home runs come to left field. That's four this year. So Allen needs to go with the pitch.
One ball and two strikes. Two outs in the inning. Gators have Brigham down at second base. Oxley over at first. The 1-2. Lined at the shortstop, Hildreth. Easy force to Masters, and Holly works himself out of a jam in the third inning. The Gators get a base hit, couple of base runners left, and after three complete, the score remains the Bulldogs 5, the Gators 3.
I'm Ray Scott, and most folks know me as a bass fisherman, but to a southern outdoorsman, hunting and bass fishing seasons go back to back. Whether it's ducks, quail, or white-tailed deer, the bottom line is being the best outdoorsman possible. That's why I'm offering you Southern Outdoors Magazine, which you can get just by calling this toll-free number. Southern Outdoors ain't a Yankee magazine. It's for Southerners like you who want to get the most out of his Southern Outdoors. Monthly issues are packed with how-to articles and exciting photography. Best of all, you get 9 big issues for only $11.97. But there's more. When you order now, from this special TV offer, this is what I'll send you.
In addition to 9 action-packed issues of Southern Outdoors for only $11.97 per year, you'll also get this special tree bark camouflage cap. Subscribe now. Call 1-800-453-9600. That's 1-800-453-9600. Use your credit card to receive your cap sooner, or we'll gladly bill you. That's 1-800-453-9600.
Dallas took Michael Irvin. Welcome back to Perry Field on a beautiful Sunday afternoon in Gainesville, Florida. Mississippi State Bulldogs have a 5-3 lead over the Gators as we move to the top half of the fourth inning. Guy has got his radio strapped on, listening to Larry Vitale on WRUF. Radio here in Gainesville, and folks watching Sports Channel all over the state and elsewhere around the United States. First pitch to Todd Nace is inside, pushed him away from the batter's box. Nace singled back in the second. The 1-0 from Dalma. Two balls, no strikes. Dalma has fallen behind the Mississippi State leadoff man here in the fourth inning, 3-0.
He doesn't want to do that with 9-1 and 2 coming up.
Walked him on 4 straight. So Nace leads off the inning with a walk. And that brings second baseman Burke Masters to the plate. He flying to left.
Stepping to the plate is the second baseman, the second. Number 23, Burke Masters.
Masters hitless in the series. And hitting at 325 for the season. Dalma, something of a token move over to first base that time.
Yeah, that was about the C move right there.
About a C plus.
That's getting better, right? That man right there, all academic SEC, as are about 4 of these players on the Mississippi State squad.
Masters from Julian, Illinois. One and one, the count. Dalma struck out the first man he faced in relief, Richie Graham, but then gave up a triple to Young, a single to Raffo. Hey, I like it. 2-1.
And sometimes Todd Dalma starts to wander a little bit. I think his concentration is doing that here with his four throws over to first base, and he's falling behind this hitter. Just as I say that, Tyson Johnson runs down to the bullpen with Joe Gaspard.
The 2-1 pitch is popped into shallow right field. Tommy Edwards going back. Brigham coming on. Brigham makes the running catch for the first down in the inning.
Well, Ned got a late jump on it. He's looking up in the sun. As I was saying, I believe it was on Wednesday, on a day like today, when the ball's hitting that sun area, if you hang with it, it'll come out of there eventually. At 5 o'clock, it'll land right in it. And there's Tyson Johnson, the right-hander.
Winford singled and scored the game's first run in the first inning. Lined out to Mendez at short in the third. He's 1-for-2. 2-for-10 in the series. Dalma keeps close watch over Todd Nace at first base. Good curve ball is in for strike one.
Boy, Dalma. Paying a lot of attention to Nace. You think you had Vince Coleman over there.
One and one. Cohen is next. And then Jody Hurst.
Nace, I believe, with only two stolen bases on the year. 2-for-3. He goes, you take your chances.
Grounded to Rutledge at third. Edwards for one. Winford beats the ramp at first.
Well, the important thing for Florida, they get the one. And what happened is Rutledge had trouble getting the ball out of his glove. He wasn't gathered enough to make the good throw to second base. The throw kind of had Tommy Edwards reaching for it, so he didn't get the good pivot at second base. So it all started on the initial play where Rutledge couldn't get the ball out of the glove. But the Gators do get the lead runner.
At bat is number 11.
And the man at first, Winford, is the guy that leads him in stolen bases with eight. 8-for-8 this year.
Cohen swings a hot bat. He's 2-for-2 this afternoon with a double and a single. An RBI and a run scored.
Dalma, a lefty, but has a fairly slow delivery, so he would not be that much of a deterrent, the fact that he's a lefty. Another key point is his delivery time.
Snap throw over to Oxley at first base. And a good cut. Count evens at 1-1. Florida won game one of the doubleheader last night, 6-5. Game two, 5-1. Mississippi State leads this afternoon's contest 5-3 in the top of the fourth with two outs. Winford running, swing and a miss. Fernandez's throw is not in time. Stolen base number 9 for Barry Winford.
It's a good pitch to go on because I believe they picked a breaking ball. You see Winford going in. It's a straight steal. He does not look back, which is the correct thing. Head first slide, and his hand reaches in for the stolen base. And one of the things I was saying is the fact that Delma was somewhere around 1.4 seconds by the time he started his delivery and by the time it crossed home plate. So that's a little bit above what you want your pitchers to keep it down till. That you want to keep them around 1-1-3, and that was a little above that. That's a theory that Roger Craig uses over at San Francisco. If they find that the opposing pitcher's delivery time is over 1-3-5, they think they can steal every time. And at least I know Roger Craig attempts it just about every time. He's got that team running.
Winford down at second in scoring position with two outs and a 1-2 pitch from Dalma. He got him with a good breaking ball. Second strikeout recorded by Todd Dalma, and the Bulldogs come up empty in the top of the fourth. We'll be right back on Sports Channel Florence.
Randy Whitman, the baseline jump shot.
Quickly up the right side. Isaiah will go all the way to the baseline. Scoop and score. What a shot.
Magic Johnson down the middle.
Oh, no, look past the Johnson.
Bird to Vincent to Bird.
Over the backboard.
Oh. America's game. It's fantastic.
Have you lost your head?
That's what I'm trying to avoid, my friend.
But Vince, if we don't belly up to the bullseye, how else can we prove that safety belts save lives?
Oh, it ain't working, Larry. Nobody's listening.
Sure they are. Look at them. They're buckled up.
Hey.
Them too.
So maybe eating all these dashboard hors d'oeuvres is worth it.
For sure.
Hey, let's head back.
Hey, buddy, I didn't know you knew how to drive.
Drive? Drive?
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Look at your safety belt.
Here's the last pitch by Todd Dalma to John Cohen. A breaking ball right at the lefty. Breaks and catches the inside corner. Cohen swings right through it. That's a nasty pitch for a left-handed hitter to have to deal with.
Now the Gators in the bottom of the fourth will send the number 9 man, Mike Moberg, to the plate. And into the top of the order with Brian Remsnyder and Tommy Edwards. Crowd not as large as last night, I don't think, but still a nice Sunday afternoon crowd. Incredible to imagine 14,000 fans at a college baseball game in Starkville, Mississippi, but that's what they had last weekend on Saturday night for an LSU doubleheader.
They're absolute fanatics up there in Starkville. They love their Bulldog baseball. And most of it is townspeople. And Ron Polk said to me that gives me an idea. They had to turn away 1,000 kids at the Ron Polk summer baseball camp last summer. Turned down 1,000.
Two balls and one strike to Mike Moberg, who doubled in the second. Has a couple of hits in the series. It was an RBI double. High chopper foul, left side of the infield. Two balls and two strikes. Moberg's a guy that came right out of high school, St. Thomas Aquinas, to the University of Florida. He bypassed what many do, and that's to take the junior college route. And he had to wait 2 years, really, to get his shot. I asked him before the game if he felt like he'd made the right choice, and he said yes. 3-2. He feels like that he's had superior coaching and handling here at the University of Florida and believes that's paying dividends for him now. The 3-2 pitch from Holly. Bouncer left side. Hildreth has a long throw. And Moberg is safe at first. That young guy has been in the center of several very close plays at first base this weekend. Mike Moberg was called out twice last night on extremely close plays. Let's take a look at this one.
Takes the outside pitch and pulls it, and it always goes to that sixth spot, but he hits it to where the fielder were not playing him, and he beats the rep.
Last night, in one of the two plays that were controversial calls, Mike started to make a turn and head for second on an infield ground ball, and we found out later that what happened was first base coach Ben Hayes was signaling with the hand to come on through the base, and Mike thought that signal was make the turn. So they had a miscommunication problem there, and it cost him a base runner.
You saw it last night in the when it happened. Mike was running back to the dugout and saying to Ben Hayes, he's circling with his hand, saying, I thought you said to circle the bag.
Rem Snyder worked Holly for a walk in his last trip, blind to right in the first inning. The 1-0 pitch. Two balls, no strikes.
I believe the Gators will play this fairly conservative. Leadoff man up 2-0 count or down two runs.
Ryan Remsteiner works Holly to a 3-0 count.
Mike Moberg bluffing a steal. I think he's just trying to distract the pitcher. Get some of the infielders moving around.
Walked him on four straight bandwins. Florida with runners at first and second. Nobody out here in the bottom of the fourth. And the heart of the Gator batting lineup still to come with Edwards, Mendez, and Linares waiting to hit.
Tracy Jobes still down in the Mississippi State bullpen throwing. Seems like he's been throwing for the last 2 days down there.
And they may be talking about how to handle a bunt situation with nobody out, Florida down by two runs. This would be a good spot for Edwards to sacrifice some folks around.
Edwards with three sacrifices so far this year. It's early in the ball game. Gators do not like the sacrifice. They will if they have to. Last night, Alan Rutledge was up there.
Your second baseman, number four.
Disguising
Tommy
the
Edwards.
Sacrifice ended up swinging away.
Infield in at double play depth. Edwards does bunt the ball. He got it over the head of the pitcher, Holly. Good play by the second baseman, Masters, and they got Edwards at first on another very close play. Tommy Edwards almost bunted himself on base and gets a nice hand from the crowd as he steps into the dugout.
Great sacrifice. What he did, it bounced on that hard dirt in front of home plate that we've been talking about as you look at the runners and got by the mound. Once it gets by the mound, it becomes dangerous, but good play over there by Burke Masters. Stuck with it, made the good underhand toss to Tommy Raffo. Otherwise, it would have been bases loaded, nobody out.
Number three man in the lineup, Julio Mendez at the plate with runners at second and third and one out in the inning. Mississippi State with a two-run lead. Here's the pitch from Holly. It's inside for ball one. Holly from the belt. Chopper down the third baseline. Young kicked it away. It's a fair ball. Moberg scores from third, and everybody's safe. The Gators with runners on the corners in a 5-4 game now. The only play that Pete Young had was to throw it across the field at first. He had no shot at the runner at home. And it'll be interesting to see how they score this one, because that would have been a tough play for Young if he'd fielded it cleanly.
Well, no word yet, but the main thing, the bottom line, is there's runners on first and third and a run in.
At bat is the designated hitter, number 13, Mario Linares.
A 5-4 ball game now, and Florida's still at bat with one out. And they've scored a base hit for Mendez. On there is lofts it high into center field. Remsnyder at third. Very shallow fly ball, but they send Remsnyder, and he's in sliding safely, easily, with the tie run.
And a real heads-up play by Julio Mendez, who is on first base. He saw it and tagged up. Lulled him to sleep, I believe, did Remsnyder, making him think he wasn't going to come home. Here comes the throw right here, and it just sails on him. Remsnyder slides in easy as the ball tailed away from the catcher. And as we mentioned, that's Julio Mendez down at second base in scoring position. So a big heads-up play by Mendez.
Surprised that the play wasn't any closer at the plate than it was.
That'll be it.
Ron Polk going to make the pitching change with two outs in the fourth inning. And he wants the left-hander, Johnson. So that's going to be all for Chuck Holly this afternoon as he works 3 2/3 innings.
And there's Wes Johnson coming on from Manti, Mississippi, 2-0, 6.61 ERA. You see, in 16 innings, he's been touched up a little bit, 18 hits, 14 walks. Came in last night's game. Pitched 2/3 of an inning, struck out one. He's the strikeout pitcher, according to Ron Polk. That's what he does best. Good breaking ball, but has to get ahead of the hitters.
Now pitching for the Bulldogs is number 10, Wes Johnson.
Moberg began the inning with a single. Remsnyder then followed with a walk. Tommy Edwards laid down a nice sacrifice bunt, moving both runners to second and third. And then Julio Mendez brought home a run on an infield base hit. Mario Linares followed with a fly ball to center field and a sacrifice fly because Remsnyder tagged and scored on a play from third. There's a one ball, no strike count to the Florida right fielder, Ned Brigham. With two outs in the inning, the Gators' Mario Linares, or rather Julio Mendez, down at second base. And a 5-5 ball game, and still a long way to go in this one. Brigham bounced out to short and singled. He's 1-for-2 in this game. Ned is 3-for-6 in the series. The left-hander Johnson delivers a fastball up high in the eyes. Two balls and no strikes. There's Julio Mendez. Hit it off the fist, bending foul out of play down the left field line.
Wes Johnson, second appearance of the weekend. Big pitch is the chase slider, or chase curveball is what he throws.
The 2-1 pitch. Grounded to second. Masters up and throwing, and the inning is over. But a productive one for the Florida Gators. They've tied the game with a couple of runs. And after four complete, we're all tied up at 5-5.
America's game. It's fantastic.
Hey, Charlie, looks like you could use a shoulder to cry on.
There's one in here somewhere.
Vince, what are you doing?
Getting out of the crash dummy business. No way I'm ending up like Charlie there.
But, Vince, how else can we prove safety belts save lives?
We could buckle up.
How many times I gotta tell you we're dummies? We don't wear safety belts.
Vince, Larry, your number's up.
Couldn't save a life.
No, I'm with you, partner.
Yeah.
Vince, break a leg.
A regular comedian.
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Buckle your safety belt.
Jody Hurst will lead off the top half of the fifth inning for Mississippi State. Hurst.
Now batting is number six, the designated hitter.
One hit in this game. And four hits in yesterday's doubleheader. He scored a couple of runs this afternoon. Facing the left-hander, the freshman Todd Dalma. The first pitch is ball one. Three, four, and five hitters against Dalma in the fifth.
Well, Dalma now the pitcher of record for Florida.
Fouled back into the screen. No balls, two strikes. His hat fell off. The wind is swirling from right to left.
Like candlestick right now. Get a shot at that flag. It's blowing right out to left field.
One ball, two strikes. Still the count on Jody Hurst. Five runs, seven hits for the Bulldogs. Five runs, seven hits for the Gators. The third game of a weekend series here in Gainesville, Florida. Florida won both ends of the doubleheader last night. And Dalma strikes him out, his third strike out of the ball game.
Let's take a look here and see the movement on this pitch by Todd Dalma. Watch the tail away from the right-handed hitter.
Now batting is a left fielder.
Pitches to be very effective in the course of this ball game. That's what I'm saying. be effective, they need to go with him. Hit it to right field if you're a righty.
Didn't have a very good cut at the breaking ball. It's 0-1. Graham struck out against Dalma in the third inning. Reached on an error in the first. He just missed. Counted 1-1. Graham from Green Cove Springs, Florida. The 1-1 pitch misses inside. Two balls and a strike. Had a good cut, but the count evens at 2-2.
He really pulled off that pitch, try to drive it out in right field. But Graham's a guy with good power to all fields, as we saw last night as he hit a home run to left field.
Struck him out for the second straight appearance. Back-to-back strikeouts for young Todd Dalma. He worked two outs in the inning.
Worked him inside and gives him the slider away. Set him up with that fastball in. Good piece of pitching by the freshman.
Pete Young has hit the ball sharply both trips this afternoon. He lined out into a double play in the first inning and tripled in the third. First pitch is low and inside, one ball and no strikes. Two and oh. Other than that triple Dalma gave up to Young in the third inning, Todd Dalma has pitched very effectively against this murderous Mississippi State attack. The 2-0 pitch. Hit on the ground to Mendez at short. Julio's throw is in time, and that's it. 1-2-3 for the Bulldogs in the top of the fifth. We move to the bottom half of the fifth inning, and we're still tied up at 5-5.
So come on, y'all. Milk's vitamins and calcium are part of it all. Milk. Way down south today, there's just one thing to say. America's favorite. Health kick.
Milk.
You're Hollandaise. Oh, I knew that. The old guard and the new wave. To tell you about another down-to-earth benefit from space research.
I can't believe these glasses for the deaf.
A tiny microphone on the frame connects to a portable computer which converts spoken words into visual cues that appear right on the lens of the glasses.
Huh. The eyes doing what the ears can't. Incredible.
Space technology.
This is what's in it for you.
Warm and humid afternoon at Florida Field. Short sleeve, short pants weather. Steve Zaire looking on, a key player in last night's first game of the doubleheader. Had an important run-scoring double in that game. And here's the guy that's playing first base here this afternoon, Tim Oxley. Oxley a double and a walk. He's one for one officially. Facing the left-hander, Wes Johnson. No balls and a strike.
If you're wondering why Oxley is still in the ball game, Jorm are probably anticipating Mike Martin coming in to close, and he's a righty.
Bending, a fair ball down the left field line. Oxley's going to have another double. He's gone the opposite way twice here this afternoon, and Mr. Sports Channel continues to tear him up on television.
You'll see him go again with the pitch. Perfect piece of hitting. The hips are going towards the line. He doesn't try to pull it, goes right with it, and that's how a lefty hits a lefty effectively. And now that's his eighth double. Six of them have been on television. And there you have it.
Oxley with a leadoff double here in the fifth.
Stepping in bat is the catcher, number 24.
And Oxley represents the lead run down at second base. Jose Fernandez singled in the second, behind the left in the third. Squares to bunt. And takes the pitch for ball one.
Now the Gators have been known to fake this play. We're only in the fifth. One would not think they'd be really bunting here.
Fernandez looked fairly serious about it that time and took the fastball inside for ball two.
He did. I guess the thought here is with the lefty throwing breaking balls away, it'll be tough for Fernandez to pull the ball, which is his job here with nobody out. Hit the ball to the right side, so they're going to make sure.
Three balls and no strikes.
And believe me, if you're the pitcher and the guy wants to give himself up, just throw him a strike. Of course, they might not be so quick to give in after what Rutledge did last night with the fake bunt.
Here's a strike. Jobes heats up again, a right-hander. The 3-1 pitch. Curveball is in for strike two.
Well, now you've set up the bunt on all five pitches. Now you got a 3-2 count. Let's see it again. This is a tough pitch to bunt. But it's one you just have to go after and bunt at the third. You want the third baseman to field the ball in this situation. Therefore, the pitch away would be an easy thing to accomplish that.
The 3-2 pitch, he walked him. Runners will be at first and second for Alan Rutledge. Nobody out in the bottom of the fifth in a 5-5 game.
And Ron Falk's coming out, and perhaps we'll finally see Tracy Jobe. Righty against righty in this situation would be the call, and it is.
So Tracy Jobes trots in from the right field bullpen, and Wes Johnson, who faced three batters, is through for the day. Johnson got Brigham to ground out to end the fourth inning, but then allowed a leadoff double here in the fifth to Oxley and walked Fernandez. That's the three that he faced. Now, Jobes, we're going to look at Alan Rutledge, Mike Moberg, and in the top of the order, Brian Remsnyder with nobody out in the top half of the fifth, and Florida with runners at first and second.
And this is the seventh appearance for Jobes, his sixth in relief. He doesn't have a record yet, 3.38 ERA. He's a guy that's been warming up pretty much every game in the last few nights.
Now pitching for Mississippi State is number 8, Tracy Jobes.
And in 16 innings, 13 strikeouts, only 4 walks.
Jobes is a sophomore from Cordova, Tennessee, Germantown High School. Another redshirt freshman, sat out last year.
He's another guy like Bobby Reed, the pitcher who normally would go on the Sunday, as we said in the opening. Bobby Reed 8-0 with a phenomenal ERA, leading the SEC, somewhere around 1.09. Who's back home in Starkville, probably watching this game with arm problems. Here's another guy that's had arm problems. Wasn't even able to pitch till up to 2 weeks ago. So here's a guy that a little bit rusty.
Actually, it wasn't last year that he sat out. He sat out 86 as a redshirt year and pitched for him last year. He was 3-2 a year ago and pitched 60 innings. And seven starts.
Now we're in a situation where we were last night. Bunt situation. Rutledge faked the bunt. Put on a little acting job, and then the next pitch swung at it.
Rutledge takes a full cut at the ball, drives it deep to left. Graham going back. This one's in the parking lot. A three-run home run for Alan Rutledge. His fifth home run of the season. And he's just jolted the Gators into an 8-5 lead. Hello, Mr. Jones.
Well, no doubt about what Alan Rutledge, if you're looking at right there, a little bit of acting last night, no acting today. Swinging all the way, high inside pitch, right on the barrel, opens the hips, rides it right out of the yard. And you gotta be aware of the fact that third baseman Pete Young and first baseman Tommy Raffo were charging on that swing. And there's timeout as some fan in left field threw the ball back in and it rolled down the right field line. There's Alan Rutledge. That's a big hit. We said right at the outset last night that the Gators need some heroes, guys like Rutledge and Zaire, and both of them have come through in this series. Brigham also with a good series.
Boberg takes a healthy cut, sends it high and deep to left field. Graham back to the wall. He made the catch for the out. He reached over the fence and made the catch. Almost back-to-back home runs for the Gators.
This ball was not hit particularly well. The wind is really blowing back. When that ball is hit, it looked routine. And going back is Graham, and outstretches and takes away a home run. Or actually an extra base hit in that part. You have to.
The left fielder number 15, Brian Remsnyder.
Martin, that would be the plan.
Stepping to the plate is number
four. But now they find themselves three runs down.
Edwards 0 for 2 officially, a sacrifice bunt his last trip. Two outs in the inning, the 0-1 pitch. Edwards chops it foul down the third base side, no balls and two strikes.
David, you'd have to wonder what the situation would be like if Bobby Reed had started this game. Of course, injuries are just as much part of the game as base hits.
Lou looping fly ball to right field. Cohen got a long way to run. It drops in for a base hit. Edwards going to leg it for two. The throw from Cohen, and Edwards is in with a double.
You know, Tommy Edwards made up his mind as soon as he got near first base. It just was going to be a double. The way the ball goes towards the line, you'll see the pitch. High pitch goes with it. Actually got it on the end of the bat enough to dunk it in. Now, what's going to happen is the ball is going to spin towards the line away from the outfielder, and Tommy Edwards heads up, decided that he had plenty of time to get to second base and makes it easily.
Third hit in the inning for the Gators. 10th hit in the game for Florida. And for Mr. Edwards, that is his ninth double of the season. Julio Mendez, with Edwards down at second base and two outs, takes the breaking ball in for strike one. Mendez with a couple of hits, couple of singles, an RBI single, his last trip. And four base hits in the series for Mendez. Mike Martin gets ready to loosen up down in the Bulldog bullpen. One ball and one strike to Julio Mendez. Round ball to Hildreth. Charging, throwing. The inning is over. But Florida got three runs thanks to a three-run blast by Gator third baseman Alan Rutledge. And after five complete, the Gators have jumped out to an 8-5 lead.
Here in spring training is where we put it all together for the coming season. You got to start early, whether it's baseball or filing your taxes. File now and you'll be less likely to overlook deductions or make last-minute mistakes. And if you got a refund coming, you're going to get it faster. So why don't you put it all together? File now, and come April, while I'm hard at work, you can just sit back and enjoy the game.
That's it. I'm history. End of the road.
You can't quit, Vince. No crash dummy takes out a utility pole like you do.
Larry, for years I've been proving how safety belts save lives, but nobody's listening.
Sure they are.
Yeah, that's why thousands die in car accidents every year. I feel like I'm banging my head against the wall.
Come on, Vince. Tomorrow's the big day. Two compacts. Get on.
High speed?
Could save a life.
No, I'll be there.
Yeah.
You could learn a lot from a dummy. Buckle your safety belt.
Alan Rutledge snapped himself out of a 1-for-20 slump with this.
A fastball high, and the first pitch from Tracy Jobes, a relief pitcher from Mississippi State, and he drove it out of the ballpark in a bunt situation with first and third charging on that pitch.
We've had some technical difficulties, and for that we apologize. Florida has taken an 8-5 lead over Mississippi State as we've completed five innings of play. And Bulldog first baseman Tommy Raffo leads off the top of the sixth to face left-hander Todd Dalma. Good fastball, one ball and one strike. Dalma's on in relief of starting pitcher Joe Klasnick, and Todd has set down seven consecutive Bulldog batters. One ball, two strikes.
Dalma very effective, and you got to consider the fact that Mississippi State eats up left-handed pitching, and the Gator left-handers are giving them fits all weekend. Her only loss to a left-handed pitcher was Johnny Witten in last night's game, and that was through 44 ball games.
Fourth strikeout of the last five batters he's faced, Todd Dalma. Let's take another look.
Todd Downey, he's getting like Johnny Wiggs. You don't know which way he's going to go, and it's the slider down and in.
The shortstop, number four, Brad Hildreth.
Brad Hildreth, the Mississippi State shortstop, 0 for 2 in the game, 1 for 8 in the series. Fastball missed outside, one ball and no strikes. What a fine stop by Rutledge. He's got time to throw him out. The throw is high, but Oxley comes down on the bag for the out.
Well, when you're hot, you're hot. Good play by that man, Oxley. Even better play by Alan Rutledge. You can see the tail end of it. Watch Oxley come down on the bag just in time, gets his foot out of there before he gets spiked. Tim Oxley sharing the marquee with Alan Rutledge here today.
Now batting is number 26, the center fielder, Todd Nace.
Two outs in the inning now for center fielder Todd Nace. A single and a walk, 1 for 1 in the game. 3 for 6 in the series. The left-hander Dalma delivers. Strike one on a curveball.
Pretty impressive stats right there for the freshman, considering he's facing the leading hitting team in the Southeastern Conference coming into this series, hitting 342 as a team.
Fernandez got a little dirt in his face. The wind swirling around there at home plate. And the 0-1 pitch from Dalma. Breaking ball, strike two.
See if he comes with that slider away.